In modern days, a good quality digital image only depends on either good quality imaging hardware or very advanced software trickery that is considered to be proprietary. So, this motivated us to try something to help us increase the picture quality of an already captured image and make that cross-platform and decentralized, not limited to only one specific phone, digital camera, or company. As a solution, we wanted to create a software which takes in a digital image and auto-fixes and enhances the image and produces the desired output results. Might sound very simple, and the actual UI would actually be very simple. However, the background functioning of the software uses many advanced techniques such as ray tracing to control the lighting of the image, deep neural networks to enhance the textures present in the image, as well as GANs to do that in a very realistic manner. As of now, we have perfected the ray tracing engine and it simulates the interaction of light in real world to the perfect extent in the software. The current working prototype of our software wholly relies on the ray tracing backbone. To have a rough idea about ray tracing is pretty simple. Just remember how the light rays interact in real world. There's a light source which emits visible radiation. The radiation bounces off from the objects, and then the light rays after interacting reaches our retina. Replace the retina with a camera. The camera producing a 2D image of the 3D world. And now reverse the direction of the light rays. That it is ray tracing. This technique is very demanding as compared to rasterization, which is a more well adopted 3D rendering model. We used GPGPU computing techniques, and NVIDIA's offering the CUDA architecture proved to be the best bet. Our ray tracing code on the GPU and its available stream processors.
Now let us review the working of our program. This is the main function which creates the 3D world through ray tracing technique. And these are the header files which we have defined, and they state the light rays which would be used to create the 3D world, the objects in the 3D world, which is sphere as of now, the material of the objects, and the physics of the interaction of the objects with the light rays. And the camera, of course, give us the perspective of the 3D world. Now, without further ado, let us have a functioning of the program. Here we have to enter the resolution at which we want to render the image. Let's enter 1920 by 1080. For a full HD image. And then we have to enter the sampling quality of the image. Let us enter 20 being a very good sampling quality. Now we have to enter the X, Y, and Z coordinates where we have to place the camera to get the 2D perspective of our 3D world. Let's select 12 X coordinates, Y 5 units, and Z being 6 units. The program has now started to render the image. And as the status bar reaches zero, it should complete the rendering. As you can see, the program has completed to run. Now let us have a look at the rendered image. This, as you can see, is a full HD image with 24 bits depth, and the sampling quality is set to 20. This 2D picture of the 3D world that the program has created is completely ray traced, and all the reflections in the world follows exactly real world dynamics.
In future, we would develop the full product which would take the input image and then process it and enhance the quality of the image. In future, we also plan to make the software available on different platforms such as macOS, Linux, as well as mobile platforms such as iOS and Android OS. For now, Windows have to suffice, but the future of our project definitely seems promising, and we hope that the deep neural network parts and GAN part gets implemented just as successfully as the ray tracing part did. Thank you very much for watching our video. This is Team Ocular Geniuses signing off.